Good day, folks. My name's Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in beautiful, sunny Eugene, Oregon. RV Corral has been around for over 26 years at the same location, helping folks find the right RV for the right price and taking care of them after the sale. I just took this trade-in yesterday. It's a 2008 Holiday Rambler Admiral 33 with the big super slide on one side. What can I share with you about it? The most important thing I could share with you is it's built on the heavy 22,000 pound Workhorse chassis. Allison 6-speed transmission with a grade brake, just under 22,000 miles. Beautiful, beautiful coach. If you're not looking to spend over $100,000 and you want to get into a nice unit, especially on the Workhorse chassis, this just might be the ticket for you. Notice we have the 22.5 tires, aluminum Alcoa wheels down below. The doors open sideways on this coach, which is really nice because you can just reach down, open the doors, and you can see how much storage you have down below. And you have the larger ones as you go back further, giving you nice storage areas down below. Chrome tip on the exhaust, which is really nice, just finishes it off perfectly. Like I say, it is a full wall slide, folks, and I do have awning toppers up above. This is what they refer to as full body paint. It's beautiful, beautiful coach. Back in the back area down here, I'm gonna open this up for you. I have my complete enclosed holding tank area. So for freeze up, you've got no worries whatsoever. 50 amp cord service with an automatic switchover valve. And we are running a 5,500 watt Onan generator in this beautiful coach. Cap on the back, backup monitor. 5,000 pound tow hitch down below. Now, as I said, I just took this in yesterday, folks, so nothing has been cleaned, as you can see in the back compartment there. The Onan generator has 57 hours on it, barely used. It does come with an outside barbecue that hooks up right here to this compartment door. This is the propane tank. And the barbecue is sitting down here in this storage compartment. I have a 10-gallon gas electric hot water heater. And I have an enclosed awning on the outside here, which, as you can see, covers the door. Double entrance steps going in. And the door is on a strut, which I really kind of like because I don't have to worry about latching the door when it's open. So Curtis, let's go inside. And folks, please grab a pen, piece of paper. I'm a salesman. I only get paid if I sell something. So hopefully I can sell you this beautiful coach. Okay, so up in front, we have the Workhorse emblem on the steering wheel. They did buy a beautiful dash mat just to cover up the dash. One piece bus windshield in the front. Flat screen sharp TV. I got a switchover box in the front, which I can switch from rear TV, front TV, cable in. I have a Blu-ray DVD player up above. Thermopane windows, day and night shades. We have a hide-a-bed sleeper in the front. Now that table and chairs, right now I have the table pushed in. There are two additional fold-up chairs and they're located underneath the bed. I'll show you that when we get there. Table extends out so we can comfortably seat four people around this area. Two ducted roof air conditioners. Notice we don't have a gas oven, so I have some more drawers down below. Microwave convection oven up above. It's a nice sharp. Counter space, couple of 110 plugs. You know, I've been motorhomes, folks, where you've only had one plug and it's been up underneath the counter. Well, how inconvenient. You've got a coffee maker, you've got a toaster. You know, so having two plugs in the wall is really, really nice. Storage up above with adjustable shelves. Stereo surround sound speakers. Like I say, folks, this whole wall is slid out. So when this comes in, you can still access your bathroom area, your fridge. I have a nice little slide-out pantry right over here to the right of the fridge. A fridge, I think, is an English word. I think that's what I used to call it when I was over in England. So I have a double door closet here with a shoe rack in the back, adjustable. Drawers down below. And as we go further back, I have another double door closet into the bedroom with six more drawers down below. I mean, you could comfortably go down to Arizona for 5 months in this motorhome. It's gorgeous. I could anyway, with my wife. More shelves down below the TV. And then let's not forget the bathroom, which is right behind Curtis as he's going back there. We'll open it up for you. And right now, folks, don't be, it's not a Halloween joke with the red stuff in the shower. That's just antifreeze that we've got. He did have everything serviced just before he brought it in, fully winterized. And I do have a full queen bed. Now, by a queen bed, I mean it's not 60 by 74. It's a full 60 by 80. And then I have the storage underneath, and there's my auxiliary chairs that I mentioned to you. Nice storage area. So when the bed doesn't slide out, you get a full storage. If the bed slides out, usually there's a slide out mechanism underneath. So very nice coach. I'm going to trade places with Curtis. Grab that pen, grab that piece of paper. I think I mentioned a couple times before, but my name is Raymond Moore. Go Ducks. It's a Duck home game tonight. I'm with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. I want to thank you ahead of time for watching this video. If you're in the market for a nice, clean, used, late model motorhome, diesel, gas, it doesn't really matter. I sell them all. Please give me a call. Stop on by. Cell phone is always on my hip. Well, most of the time, except if I'm sleeping. So thanks again, folks, and have a great day. Go Ducks!